Again, welcome back to Air Engine Research. Thanks for looking in, and any new viewers, you're welcome to subscribe to my channel and join with us if you'd like. I recently posted about looking over what I have worked on since starting to actually build an air engine that would work in a regular sized car or a pickup. But before I do that, I'd like to tell you about where I currently am and where I'd like to go with my project. I started to build a machine using off-the-shelf parts, kind of like hardware store buying tubing, pipe, and local places for materials, and then I would make anything that I couldn't get that would work, you know, just as it was. I have been successful in making several variations of an air engine that I think would be usable in my Ram 50 5-speed pickup truck. But all the first prototypes had bad valve air leakage that I think I now have solved. I haven't really decided which one of those prototype reciprocating engines that I would like to work with best. But there is also a design that I've been thinking about the last year for a rotary type engine that would be a lot simpler and wouldn't have valves at all. But again, sealing would have to be worked out on the rotary part of it. So in my later sessions, I will want to talk more about that. I did start thinking about building a air motor long before 2014, when I bought my milling machine and drill machine. So back then, with starting with the air motors, I didn't really consider too much or think much about what the consequences might be with a vehicle putting one in it. I just wanted to build a compact motor that would work in a car or pickup. I wanted to just be able to take the old motor out, hook up a new air motor to the transmission and go. Now I wonder if there would be some problems with transmissions maybe, and what all, since the only time the transmission would turn would be when the engine is running or when the motor is moving. I can think of some other things too. There wouldn't be any hot water for heat in the wintertime, and there might be some problems getting high pressure air traveling away from home. Excuse me. Air conditioning. Well, since you have expanding air, you have cooling, so I guess we could do something with that for air conditioning. I have some videos and drawings that I will like to show at the beginning of each one of my sessions, and we can discuss, you know, how they look, how they work, what you think about them, any comments or suggestions. As you know, I'm going to be trying to use live streaming, so there may be some strange things that happen. So bear with me, please. My channel, if you want to subscribe, is youtube.com/live/air-engine-research, all in one word. And you can go there, and if you're not a subscriber, then you can also subscribe there. I'm also planning on having a live session every Tuesday and Friday at 7 p.m. once I get things worked out. Well, I hope to have you involved in my future sessions, but right now I'm going to sign off and get to work on some of the things that I need to and try to figure out how to work some of the things. I noticed at the bottom of the live session there's a chat window that I don't know anything about yet or how to use it, so maybe we can figure that out together. So until my next session. I'm going to go ahead and sign off for now. So long.